Hello and welcome Summer Channel. Please subscribe, like and share. If you have any suggestions on tutorials you wanna know how to do some, whether it's the DS Photoshop, make videos, how to do anything hacking modern computer related, only known comments and I will do a video on that. Now let's enjoy this video.
Forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.
Alright guys, welcome. Today I'm going to be doing a quick tutorial on Photoshop Elements 11. If you guys are wanting to get into graphics, if you've never done graphics, I recommend that you download a free program called Pixlr Editor. It's what I started on. After that, one of the most user-friendly Photoshops is Photoshop's Elements, and I'm going to show you today just how easy it is. Now the program cost about $99 and I've had mine for about 6 years. Alright, the first thing you're going to want to do is to find yourself a background. Okay, so we're just going to come on the computer and find something to work with here. Let's see. Let's go with this. Alright, now that we have this, say you wanted to, you know, add a character to it or something. We'll find some kind of little alien we can add in there just to show you how it's done. Let me find one. Alright, let's go over the tools on the left hand side here. This is zoom in, this is to grab things, move around, this is kind of the same thing. Here's your crop tool. You can crop in squares, you can crop in circles. To undo those crops, hit the lasso, and now lasso is also for cropping out things. Next we have this, the magic wand. That's what I'm going to use right now. So basically it detects edges and saves you a ton of time. Bam, copied. So you would hit copy under edit, edit, paste. There's our alien. Alright, now say you wanted to lighten them up or whatever. We have lighten, brightness. I tend to put a little bit more contrast and then bring my brightness down some. We'll do the same on the background. And then once you're done, you don't want to merge layers until you're finished. That way you can finish the project and then hit undo a couple times and have your layers in case you want to change something. Alright, now for text. I assume most of you guys know how to save your fonts. You can go online and search fonts. You simply go into your C drive or your computer, then go to Windows, then fonts, and you would download a font. It would be in a zip file, and you would drag the actual font into here and that's how you get your own fonts into Photoshop. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and choose the font we want to use right now. We'll go with something like this. We'll pick our size. Once you're done with it, you're going to want to position it to where you want. Don't worry about color unless you're just going to stick with plain text. Next thing I do is I come over here to the Effects tab. And for text, the most things you're going to want to use is glass buttons, strokes, neon, and plastic. So I'm going to start off with some neon. We're going to go with the blue. Then I'm going to go to plastics. We're also going to go to blue. Then I'll go to strokes, which will put an outline around it. And then anything you put on there, you can then edit with this little button here. See, I can change the outline color. I want green. See how green looks. Then once you have it, you can make it bigger, smaller. You can also change your bevel on the text or on the stroke, whatever you have open. Here's another cool feature. You can take your text, you have to highlight it, come down here to this right here. You can arch it. You can do all kinds of things as you see here. Also, you can make your text run up and down. You want that. So that's how that's done. Alright, some of your other tools. This is your paintbrush. Of course, with the caps on, you will not see how big your circle is, but you can make your circle bigger, smaller. And that would be for, you know, highlighting, covering, painting. You have your eraser. You have a paint bucket. Now, your paint bucket can be a regular color, or it can be a gradient pattern. So you choose that, put about that much opacity. Go to gradient, or that would be a paint, so we could just hit everything at once because we're on paint right now. So if we wanted to do the background, bam. This right here is another gradient. This is mostly for like text and stuff, so I could draw a line through it and it puts the lines in. There's many different things. You'll have to go through it yourself and see all the different features. Next we have a I don't know what you would call it, basically a color matching tool. Say I wanted to make his eyes the same color as this green. I would take my little eyedropper and sample the color. Here's a line tool. Just basically makes lines. You can make them bigger or smaller by changing the number in the box. Alright, we're going to undo those. There's your text. Here's a pencil tool. Here's some shapes. This I've never really used too much. And that's about it. Another thing down here under graphics. By type, you have pre-built text, so you can actually just drag this over, and whatever font you're using is the font that it will use. And that's it. Then you also have like background imagery. Shit, I don't know why I did that. Let's see. So you got graphics, little tons of things. You got shapes, and all that's right there. Once you're done, of course, you want to hit File and Save for Web, or you can Save As to save it as a Photoshop file. And that's basically it. I hope you guys enjoyed this and learned something from it. If you have any questions, comment below and I will respond. Peace.